Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to the third episode of Christmas Quest. So we're just gonna get right into it, guys. How has your week been? It's been a good few days since the last episode, so I figured we can keep the book and quill in there. Actually, I want to do something with these book and quills. I want to keep them in a special spot because, come with me. I want to keep the book and quills in a special spot, I think, for the series, guys. So we're gonna head down here into this room here, and I think this is where we're gonna store the book and quills. So where did the dog go? You're coming with me today, buddy. So guys, I have a few pretty cool plans for today's episode. Now, in the last episode, we rescued Buddy. Take a seat. We rescued him. The cave, I believe, is right here on the mountain. But today, guys, we're going over here. This is Pufferfish Peninsula, as you can see. Well, no, this is actually not a peninsula. This over here would be Pufferfish Peninsula, if it was named that. This is Pufferfish Bay. Pufferfish Bay is an ocean made up of this here and this incline here. We're gonna be heading there today because the fishing in Pufferfish Bay is some of the best fishing on the entire island. I heard this from one of my friends. He told me off camera, Pufferfish is the best fishing on the island. CM Brockman, let me know. Come on out. Come on, buddy, you can get through the door. Yes, you can sit. I don't know, I feel like we're risking things if we take him, but we rescued him, we may as well make use of him, but I do believe there's a fishing rod in here for us. Yes, there is. We'll just put this in our inventory here. So we got a fishing rod. We're not gonna be playing survival games today, guys, so we don't really need to PvP with this. We can leash our dog if we want. Alright, buddy, you ready? So let's go. So if we take the map, we can easily see we can't see a thing. But I do believe I know the quickest route to get to Pufferfish Peninsula. Basically, what we're gonna wanna do is, and also guys, I do apologize, I have a sore throat. It's either a sore throat or my voice is completely going out. We will see which one it is. Buddy, I'm not doing this today, friend. You're gonna have to keep up with me. You know what? I don't wanna risk it. You're gonna stay here for today. Have fun on the path, and we are gonna head down to Pufferfish Bay. So let's just take the mountainside. I do apologize. As I said before, my voice is going out, and hopefully it won't completely go out and I won't be able to record or do anything like that. We'll just assume I have pink lemonade next to me. So hopefully it'll stay, but here we go. Now, usually during the summer, Pufferfish Peninsula it's very warm here during the summer. And this entire bay is usually completely water. It's not ice, there's no snow. But the bay, this is like the gully part of the bay. It goes pretty far. It comes out here, and then after right here, it splits off and goes into the main part of the sea. This is sort of like the delta of the river right here. And then it goes into the main portion of the sea, which eventually, if we continue to run, eventually it gets into far enough away from the climate zone here. It gets, oh god, fell in the water. It gets, oh my goodness, oh, it's so deep here, which is freaky to think about. I wonder what kind of, like, whoa, let me out, please. It's freaky to think about what kind of sea creatures might be down there. Maybe a temple or something. Maybe we can explore a temple in a later date, maybe if we can find one. I keep falling in, this is not fun. But we have to do a few things in order to go fishing today, guys. One of the things we have to do is we have to dig a hole in the ice. Now, this may seem easier said than done, but I don't know how many holes in the ice there are. So here is the main portion of Pufferfish Bay. This is the bay part. Back there's the gully. This is an island here. It's completely uninhabited. So I don't even think there are animals on this island, but I could be proven wrong. There is a few different types of plant life, like these flowers, like these peonies here. But other than that, it's mostly just trees. So it's weird. There's not much here. I mean, there are rabbits. Hello. But there are rabbits all over the island. Essentially Rabbit Island. But today, guys, oh god, don't go away. We need to dig a hole in the ice. So let's just go ahead here. Let's begin digging a hole. Now, I don't know how long it'll take before the ice thaws again. So we're gonna have to do this fairly quickly. I wanna get a few different fish. I wanna try to get a pufferfish. Maybe we'll get lucky, but pufferfish are very rare to catch. So I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't actually manage to catch one. Now, when you cast your fishing rod, the fishing rod goes out fairly far, so making a nice long ice patch, a water patch, is important. Now, let's just go down here quickly. Oh god, it's freezing. Let's just see what we got here. It seems to go down. Oh god, the ice is already starting to thaw. We gotta hurry this up, guys, because we don't want the ice to completely thaw on us while we're fishing. If the ice, no, stop. That was quick. Okay, There we go. I think we're good. I think we're good. All right. So let's just jump up here and let's begin fishing. See, that's what I was worried about. There we go. So now what we need to do is we need to wait for that bobber here to go down. And we should see, if the fish comes towards us, we should see a little animation of bubbles that are going to swim towards the fishing rod. And hopefully that means we get a fish. I do believe with 1.8 or 1.7, fishing is faster than it used to be. So hopefully we can get hold of this fish here before the ice completely fills up, which it seems to be doing right now. And that fish sank to the bottom. But I think we got one. Okay, we just got a normal raw fish. All right, let's... No, I don't want to drop it. I want to take inventory of what kind of fish we get. So let's just head back up here. Okay, let's put the fish in our inventory here. And let's go ahead and let's break apart all this ice again so we can fish again. Okay, come here. Break. Thank you. Oh, we need to be breaking this with our axe. Because, obviously, axes cut ice. Okay, got you and you. All right, let's go fish again. We gonna get a fish? Yes, we are. Oh, no, I don't think that works. Go back up. There we go. Well, that's physics for you. Okay, is that gonna work? Yeah, we go. There we are. Nice little bobber in the water. Let's hopefully we can get a fish. Pink lemonade is needed right now. Because I can barely talk. It would be cool. One thing I think would be cool if they added to Minecraft would be like... sort of like a feature where you can see the actual fish. I want to see fish mobs. That way you can actually see the fish swimming up to your bobber, and then you can see it, maybe like an animation of it grabbing hold of the fishing rod. The ice is slowly breaking. Well, not breaking. It's slowly reforming right next to us. This is not good. We got to get this fish fast. I want to get a puffer fish and a clownfish, I think. Clownfish, I believe, are... Oh, wait. Oh, whoa. Were those bubbles? Oh, yeah. Bubbles. Bubbles? What? Did we miss it? Hello? Did we get the fish? We should probably put the raw fish in our inventory just so we see if we get another raw fish. But I waited too long there. Ugh, so irritating. Let me just break this again. This is going to be a long and tedious task, I will tell you guys. Maybe we should go off. Maybe we should look for a different fishing spot, because there are different fishing spots all across the bay that we can attempt to use. Like maybe on this side of this hill here, maybe there's a better fishing spot like right here. So let's just break this here. Let's maybe go for a smaller, more linear fishing spot this time. So we'll build like a 2x2 maybe. That might work a little bit better. We'll test that out. So let's just break you. We should be breaking it with our stone axe. I would like to get like a silk touch pick or something so we can get this ice back maybe and use it for like a build or something. But we will see. No. Stop reforming. The ice is just, it's not cooperating with us today. Come on. There we go. I don't even know if that works. Come on. There we go. Hopefully we can get a fish from this. Let me just get a sip of my pink lemonade here, and hopefully we can get a bite fairly quickly in this fishing rod line. Oh, there's a squid here, though. Hello, squid. Can we go ahead and break this while we're fishing? Yes, we can. Whoa. I see a fish. Swimming up towards us. Or that's just the water. That's a weird animation the water has right now. Oh, no. Oh. And another raw fish. Okay, let's attempt this again. Freaking get out of here, ice. Okay. That animation's irritating. All right, there we go. Hopefully, I want to attempt to get at least one other type of fish. I feel like if we just get raw fish, it's going to kind of be useless when we just got rid of our rod. Great. If we only get raw fish, it's going to be kind of useless to us because... What are you doing here? What are you doing there? Rod. No, we don't want. We should probably back this up a little bit. Like so. Just so we don't get caught on the ice. There we go. Hello? That's weird. There we go. Now let's hope we can get a fish from this one here. This is a fairly long one right now, so we'll see what happens. Actually, we need to swim over there. We need to... break this ice quickly. There we go. And let's back up. Okay. Come on. And a third raw fish. That's amazing. I gotta say, the fishing skills that I have brought to the table today are truly amazing. Let's go for one more fish, guys. I think we have time for one more sea creature because I've currently been recording this episode for 9 minutes. and maybe we can get a final fish. That would be oh, hello, squid. How you doing? Maybe we can just take that squid as a prize. That'd be cool. If we could maybe, if we could fish up the squid, and we can maybe get like calamari or something from it. Even though that logic doesn't really work, we'll see. We need to break this ice here. Come on. It's getting dark. We're gonna have to head back in a second. I don't think we're gonna get another fish, guys. This is not good. The ice is slowly reforming. Come on, and it looks like it might be starting to rain. Whoa, hello? Do we have something biting? Huh. Looks like we're not gonna get anything else, guys, but yeah, we need to head back because it is getting dark and we do not want to leave Buddy home alone. Like the movie, Home Alone. You get it? You get the reference? You get the reference? Yeah, I see how you're doing. Let's head back up, guys. And it looks like we got 3 fish for our efforts today, which is pretty terrible. I want to maybe take tomorrow. I'm not going to record it for you guys, but I'll take tomorrow. I'll head out and I'll do a day of fishing. And maybe we can get some fish or something. We can make a cool dish with it. We'll see what happens. But I believe our dog is a little bit deeper down on the path. So let's hopefully get to see if we can reclaim him. Hopefully he hasn't been kidnapped by whoever kidnapped him the first time. You here, buddy? You're here. You're a cute little doggy. Here you go. Alright, come up here, buddy. Literally, your name is Buddy. Let's go up here, and I have 3 fish for you. Do you love me? Come on. Where'd you go? Every time. This dog is fairly smart. The gang is also fairly stupid. But yeah, guys, we're gonna end off today's episode here. If you enjoyed, please be sure to leave a comment down below, and Buddy will definitely come, and he'll come and join us in a second. But yeah, guys, as always, I've been LP, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.